Good evening, students. Today we are going to do evidence-based reading, paired passage. Now, when we are talking about paired passage, we have already told you that on the reading part, when you will have three single passages, they are bigger, and one paired passage. When we talk about paired passage is basically a combination of two passages. You will have some questions from the first passage, some questions from the second passage, and cumulatively 3-4 questions from the both the passages. So let's start with the paired passages. Now, when we talk about a paired passage, we're talking about a topic called acidity. One thing about paired passages that definitely most of the times you'll have two passages that talk of different perspectives. That's how you'll be able to compare both of them. They will be written by two different authors and they'll be shorter than your normal passages. Generally, your passages, each one passage would be around 90 lines, but whereas in both these passages cumulatively will form into 95 lines. It depends from 85 to 95 lines, that is what it is. One more thing, it is easier to score on individual passages because if they will range from 10 to 12, the questions, 4 questions will come from the first passage, 3 to 4 questions will come from the second passage, and cumulatively, depending on the number of questions, 2 to 3 questions come from both the passages. So, even if you don't have the understanding to do the cumulative sentences, questions which would be easier, but still, at least you will be able to score on the individual passages and they would not be less than 7 to 8. Therefore, 7 to 8 questions being right is not a small thing. Okay? So, let's start with paired passages. One more thing about the paired passage is that comparatively they are shorter, as I have told you, and they could be they also talk about two different things, I mean on the same subject. So let's see what this passages talk about. Now I will not be able to take the screen because generally when we are doing the reading passages, we need to have the questions here and the passage here. So let's start. Again, here you could decide what is it that you would want to do. Would you like to create a flowchart or you would just want to go to the questions and start doing the answers? But I prefer making a flowchart. Comparatively for anything, making a flowchart is an easier way out. Let's start in this. We have in the past century, due to the burning of fossil fuels in energy plants and cars, acid rain has become a cause of harm to the environment. Now, this topic is about acid rain. It is not necessary that you have to write here. You can also underline whatever you would want to say. For example, you can underline phrases to understand how the flow of the passage is going. Okay? If at all you are not able to underline, then you can make a note. That is up to you. Now, this is going to be about acid rain is what we understand from the first few lines of the paragraph. Let's start. However, rain would still be slightly acidic even if these activities were to stop. Now, basically we are going to talk about the acid rains. Let's go to the last line to create, understand what is it that they want to talk about acid rains. Let's see. The environment can handle slightly acid rain. It just cannot keep up with the level of acid rain caused by burning fossil fuel. Now, this is one thing that they are going to talk about. So, let's see what are the next passage is going to talk about. So, now you will have the answers here. So, we will come back before we make the questions. Let's start. Passage 1 question most strongly suggests that. Let's see what it is. We'll go to the next paragraph. pH of 7 is considered neutral, while pH below 7 is acidic and pH above 7 is alkaline. Now, this is the most important part. Please note that. Now, here he is going to talk about the pH value of the water. The watering soil contains alkaline materials that will neutralize acids. That means, in the next paragraph, he is going to talk about alkaline materials. Now, when we are talking about alkaline materials, he is going to talk about, although this matter can easily handle slightly acidic rain that occurs naturally. Let's go to the next paragraph. Anthropomorphic causes of acid rain, such as the burning of fossil fuels, release nitrogen oxide and sulfur oxide gases. Now, in the next part, they are going to talk about the sulfur oxide gases and nitrogen oxide gases. Let's go to the next paragraph. Now here you will see that we are talking about the pH value of the rainwater. Check this. And then we are going to talk about, it is going on talking about strong acid. Let's go to the next slide. And here starts the second passage. Okay. So now you will see that the passage before was not even 40 lines, right? See, the passage is not even 40 lines. That means getting to do 4 questions, because here it says passage 2. Therefore, we have almost 4 questions that will come from passage 1. Therefore, it is going to be easier to make sure to get these questions correct, okay? Rather than having a longer passage, it is better to have 4 questions from a shorter passage and 4 more questions from the second passage. Let's read the second passage. So, therefore, we can say that in this whole paragraph, they spoke about acid rain. In the second paragraph, they spoke about the burning fossil oils. In the third paragraph, they spoke about the pH level, pH value. And they spoke about, in the fourth paragraph, they spoke about the alkaline materials. Here, they spoke about the nitrogen oxide and the sulfur oxide that is released out of acid rain. And in the last paragraph, they spoke about the strong acid. Soil and water become more acidic and remain that way as they are unable to neutralize the strong acid. Because the rainwater is of less 3 or less, therefore it becomes more acidic. This is for Let's go to the second passage now. Now, this is about the second passage. In the second passage, we are talking about, in humans, Keeping a constant balance between acidity and alkalinity in the blood is essential. Now, they're talking about, till now, they were talking about the environment. In this passage, they are talking about the human beings. So, therefore, we have to understand that they're talking about the alkalinity in the blood. That is the, now we are again going to create a flow chart. Before we created a flow chart where they spoke about alkalinity in the atmosphere and how it is released and how, what is the value and stuff like that. So now we have to check what it talks about the human beings. Let's start. Here it talks about the alkalinity in the blood. Then in the second part they talk about several systems are in place because, see, you have your questions here. Let's go to the second one, to keep pH constant within the necessary range. Now, they talk about several systems require a pH constant within the necessary range. Now, in the second part, they talk about three substances. In the first one, spoke about sulfur and nitrogen. And pH volume in the body, control in the body talks about carbon dioxide, carbon oxide and bicarbonate ions. Here it talks about the carbon dioxide in the body. Excess carbonic acid lowers the pH level. So here it talks about this. Let's go to the next part. Now here, the kidneys store bicarbonate ions and will release or absorb them to help adjust the pH of the blood. Now it talks about the kidneys. In the next part, they talk about, in a healthy body, these systems automatically neutralize normal amounts of acid base and maintain blood pH. Okay, so I don't think here we have to talk much about it. Here, if I can make sure the kidneys, it is more than enough. You will see, in the first part, we had four questions that spoke about the first passage. That questioned from the first passage. Here, you can see, until the 10th question, that means 5 questions were given from the second passage. Therefore, scoring on individual level 4 and 5 are easier. In some cases, these systems can be overwhelmed. This can happen to people with diabetes. Now, they are talking about the insulin level in the body. Clear? Now, they talk about if the kidneys exhaust their supply of carbon dioxide, we were speaking about kidneys, they actually basically take in and take out, so that's how they are going to make it, right? So if they exhaust their supply of bicarbonate ions, let's see what happens. Now we have 80 lines, clear? So it is comparatively smaller, right? Let's check what is it here. And the lungs cannot remove carbon dioxide fast enough to raise pH. All of the other functions in the body begin to fail. Now, if the kidneys exhaust more energy, then the lungs also cannot remove carbon dioxide. See, therefore, this becomes very important that we know what it is that is going to talk about. So, you will see in the first passage, we spoke about how the the pH value and how it comes from where it comes, how the acid rains happen and what it is going to do, what is the pH value of the rain, everything has been given. Here, they are talking about the body. So, you understand that both the options in both the cases, you have different things coming up and going. Now let's complete the passage. The system will then keep the blood pH constant as long as the production of acid waste does not exceed the body's capacity to neutralize them. Okay, so let's see. Therefore, this also completes the passage when the level is constant. Okay, so therefore now we are going to go to the questions. You will see only two questions are given from the both the passage cumulatively. So let's start answering the questions. Let's go to the first question. Okay, let's go to the first passage and the question there. We have made the flow chart. It will be easier for you to answer the question with the flow chart. Passage 1 most strongly suggests that the environment will be damaged, seriously damaged, if people do not reduce the burning of fossil fuels. So where do you think we should go? We should go to the beginning lines of the passage. Let's go. Let's see the options and eliminate the options. The environment will be seriously damaged if people do not reduce the burning of fossil fuels. Scientists must find a way to introduce more alkaline materials into the water supply to combat acid rain. Acid rain will not be a problem in the future as we move away from fossil fuels and towards alternative energy sources. Acid rain water is more of a problem than acidic soil because soil contains more alkaline materials. So let's see here, let's go to the first passage. In the past century, due to the burning of fossil fuels in energy plants and cars, acid rain has become a cause of harm to the environment. However, rain would still be slightly acidic even if these activities were to stop. Acid rain would continue to fall, but it would not cause the problems we see now. The environment can handle slightly acidic rain. It just cannot keep up with the level of acidic rain caused by burning fossil oils. Do you think we can get the answer here? The environment will be seriously damaged if people do not reduce the burning of fossil oil. Scientists, now I think the answer is A. Please check the answer. Let's go to the next question. Here in the first passage, it is A. Let's go to the next passage. Let's see the questions here. Which choice provides the best evidence for the answer to the previous question? Now, this was a part of the paired answers. So, we have to find the answers alternatively, whether you choose the first question or the second question, whichever one you would want to see it. 11 to 9, 12 to 14, 17 to 18, and 25 to 27. As we have found the answer in the first slide itself, and there we had only till 7 to 9, therefore our answer will be line 7 to 9. We don't even have to go. I told you it is easier, you know, if it was a purpose of the passage question or something like that, comparatively science passages are easier. So in this kind of a passage you need not even go to the other line numbers, because already you have the answer that has come from 7 to 9, and the first A is the answer even for the second question. Let's go to the next one. According to the information in passage 1, which pH level for rainwater would cause the most damage to the environment? Now here we have answers here 2.25, 4, 5, 9.1. Let's go and check the answers here. Here it talks about rainwater is acidic, it talks about the neutral level. I think around in the you have the rainwater pH level here. The pH of rainwater is less 3 or less. Such a low pH requires much more alkaline material to neutralize. So which level do you think is the answer? Which should be the answer? In the third one also the answer is 3. A. Because it has to be lesser than 3. Therefore, 2.25 is the level where it is lesser. Therefore, this is the right answer. Let's go to the next question. Now here, as used in line 17, tolerate most nearly means. Let's go to line number 17. Line number 17, here the tolerate word is here. Let's check what it is. It is a weak acid, even the large amount of it will not lower the pH of water much. Soil, lakes and streams can tolerate slightly acidic rain. Tolerate is can accept. Let's go to the options. Accept, A, B, endure, C, acknowledge, 4, distribute. Let's check what is the answer. Now here, according to it, A is the right answer, okay? But at the same time, endure is also there. It is not only accepting, but it also tolerating. I mean, you are enduring it. Therefore, in both these options, one has to be right. But we can see the other options also. Acknowledge. Rain does not acknowledge pH level. So, therefore, you will eliminate the option. The next one is distribute. We are not at all talking about distribution of pH value. Therefore, we will eliminate this option. The remaining are accept and endure. Please make sure never to leave any option. If I said accept, don't just find that word and give a tick mark. Rather, always try to see the other options also. If you have synonyms for the same answer, make sure to acknowledge that first. Therefore, now here, it is not only accepting, but it is also enduring. Tolerating in this context is enduring. Therefore, B is the right answer. Let's go to the next question. Passage 2 most strongly suggests that. Now here, you see that out of 11 questions, the first four questions were from passage 1 and they were pretty easy. Let's go to the next passage. Passage 2 most strongly suggests that a pH of 7.5 is ideal for blood in the human body. Acid waste in blood multiply if not neutralized. The normal range of blood pH narrows as a person ages. Small amounts of acid waste in the blood are a normal condition. Let's see the passage first. Now here it says about in humans keeping a constant balance between acidity and alkalinity in the blood is essential. If blood pH level drops below 7.5 and rises above 7.74, all of the functions in the body are impaired and life-threatening conditions can soon develop. Therefore, let's go to question number 2 and check what is the answer. Here, a pH of 7.5 is ideal for blood in the human body. We are not going to get this answer. This is basically a purpose of the passage question. And for the purpose of the passage question, we have to read the other parts of the passage too. Here, in this, in the first passage, when we, the moment we see 7.35, we generally come to a question, answer that the moment we see 7.35, we say, yes, I got the answer here. Here it says a blood pH drops below 7.35 or rises above 7.45. It never said that 7.35 is the ideal. Did it say it is the ideal one? A pH of 7.35 is ideal for blood in the human body. It did not say that. So, we generally tend to, you know, tick the right first option. If you go back to the passage, you will see that it never said that. Did it say it is ideal? No. Therefore, many processes in the body produce acid waste, which would lower the pH of body, blood, below the safe level. It said safe level. It did not say ideal level. Unless neutralized. Several systems are in place. Now, fifth question is also a paired question. When it is a paired question, I think we should say take the advantage of the line numbers. Clear? So, let's take the advantage of the line numbers. 38 to 41. Definitely A is not the right answer. Let's go to 46 and 47. Certain conditions, however, can cause acids to be made faster than the systems can react. Most of the pH control involves three related substances. Now, in this passage, it talks about the substances. Therefore, we cannot rely on the second option. Let's go to the third option, 60 to 64. Now, here it says, in contrast, breathing more slowly has the opposite effect. In a healthy body, these systems automatically neutralize normal amounts of acid waste and maintain blood pH within the very small range necessary for the body to function normally. I think here we got the right answer. Still, we will definitely go to the last 67 to 70. We'll go there too. Here it says, this can happen to people with diabetes if their blood sugar levels drops too low for too long. I don't think this is the right thing. So, we'll go with option C. If we go with option C, if when we go to the first question, then the option is going to be here. A pH of 7.35 is ideal for blood in the human body. Is a wrong one. It is not an ideal one. Acid waste in the body multiply if not neutralized. Yes, but this is not the complete thing that suggests that. It is not the purpose of the passage. The normal range of blood pH narrows as a person ages. We are not talking about that too. We are saying the last, let's see the last option. Small amounts of acid waste in the blood are a normal condition. This is the right option. Clear? Therefore, in this kind of a question, when it is complex, we should always take the help of the or the privilege of going to the second question, finding the line numbers, checking the answers there and bouncing back to the main questions. Let's go to the next question. In line number 74, exhaust mode most nearly means, we have spoken about exhaust. When the body exhausts, it talks about the body exhaustion. Let's go there. Here in line number 74, it says the waste produced from breaking down fats is blood. So the blood pH drops. If the kidneys exhaust their supply of bicarbonate ions. Now here, exhaustion here means reducing, I presume. So let's go back to the question. Here, let's check what is the answer. What are the options? Seventh one, fatigue. Fatigue means a sort of tiredness. Definitely that is not the answer. Consuming, no, it is exhausting, that is reducing. So, consuming is not the right option. Deplete, deplete also means reducing, therefore it can be the right answer. But still, we have not come down to the last option. So, let's check the last option. Dissolve, we are not talking about dissolving it, we are talking about reducing it. Therefore, this is not the right option. Therefore, we take this C. Let's go to the next question. The eighth one. Which of the following plays a role in the environment most similar to the role played by excess bicarbonate ions in the blood? Now, the eighth question is basically a amalgamation of both the passages. So, here we have to see which one is similar in both the cases. Definitely, which of the following plays a role in the environment most similar to the role played by excess bicarbonate ions in the blood? Which one? Now, here it talks about the moment we see bicarbonate ions here, we will want to use the sulfur oxide gases because both of them are chemicals. But no, we are not going to get to that. What we have to understand is what is bicarbonate ions and how is it similar to the other thing there. So let's check that first. Let's be in the second passage only, but let's see what bicarbonate ions are. We have the bicarbonate ions here. Bicarbonate ions are formed when the carbonic acid releases a hydrogen ion. Excess carbonic acid lowers the pH while excess bicarbonate ions raise it. Is it clear? Let's see what the sulfur oxide does. Let's go to the first passage now. Here we talk about this. See, anthropomorphic causes of acid rain, such as the burning of fossil oils, release nitrogen oxide and sulfur oxide gases. See, in this we are talking about the sulfur dioxide gases, but we have to go a bit higher. The soil, water and soil contain alkaline materials that will neutralize acids. These include, yes, I think we got the answer here, some types of rocks, plants and animal waste and ashes from forest fires. Altogether, these materials can easily handle the slightly acidic rains that occur naturally. The alkaline waste and ashes will slowly be used up, but more will be made to replace it. Therefore, this is the answer. Now, played by the bicarbonate in the blood. Bicarbonate in the blood basically releases a hydrogen ion, and what it does is it excess carbon lowers the blood level and while excess bicarbonate raises it. Clear? Therefore, the answer is ashes from the forest fires. Ashes from the forest fires can basically handle the forest fire, or slightly handle it. The environment can actually tolerate it. And the same way, bicarbonate ions also try to regulate the excessive, pH value, or reducing it. It is possible. So that is B is the right answer. Let's go to the next one. Based on the information passage 2, which of the following can cause the body to break down fats to use for energy? So now we are going to talk about the second one. Let's see which one has it. What does an excess of carbonic acid do? Let's see, the kidneys store bicarbonate ions and will release or absorb them to help adjust the pH of the blood. The next one, breathing faster removes more carbon dioxide from the body, which reduces the amount of carbonic acid. In contrast, breathing more slowly has an opposite effect. So an excess of carbonic acid, we are talking about the breaking down of fats. Therefore, an excess of carbonic acid does not work. Low blood pH, let's talk about. In a healthy body, these systems automatically neutralize normal amounts of acid base and maintain blood pH within the very small range necessary for the body to function. So, low blood pH can definitely. Therefore, in some cases, these systems can be overwhelmed. This can happen to people with diabetes if their blood sugar drops too low for too long. People with diabetes do not make enough insulin, which the body uses to release stored fats, stored sugar into the blood to supply the body with energy. If a person's insulin level gets too low for too long, the body breaks down fats to use for energy. So the answer for this question is, what does following can cause the body to break down fats to use for energy? A drop in blood sugar or not enough insulin. Therefore, the first two options are eliminated. We cannot have the first two options. The answer is here. Okay, so let's check the answer first. So therefore, people with diabetes do not make enough insulin, which the body uses to release stored sugar into the blood to supply the body with energy. If a person's insulin level gets too low for too long, the body breaks down the fats to use for energy. Therefore, this is the answer here. We will go to answer number D. A drop in blood sugar, definitely. But when the drop in blood sugar happens, see, these two are very closely related. One is the cause and the other one is the effect. Okay, so we have to see a drop in blood sugar can be the right answer, but we are talking about the result. Therefore, D is the right answer. Let's go to the next question. Which of the following best describes the shared purpose of authors of both passages? Now, this is basically a cumulative question, and from 1 to 4, we had questions only from passage 1. From 5 to 7, we had questions only from passage 2. And from there, we are having questions from both the passages. Now, let's see. Now, we have a proper idea about what the passages are about. So, let's check the answers. To encourage readers to care for delicate systems such as environment and human body. We have not spoken about taking care at all. Let's see what is the answer. Go to the next option. To explain how the human body neutralizes acid waste that it produces and blood deposits in the blood. We are talking about both the passages. Whereas the second option talks only about passage 1. To describe systems that can neutralize small amounts of acid but become overwhelmed by large amounts. This could be, we are talking about systems, that means in both the cases. So, this could be one answer. Let's go to the last option. To persuade readers to work towards reducing acid rain by cutting consumption of fossil oils. In the entire passage that has been given, probably a part of it, never spoke anything about it. So, the question could be, the answer could be between A and C. Why A and C? Because this talks only about the human body and this talks only about the environment. Both the authors wrote on different topics, so definitely both of them are eliminated. This first one is to encourage readers to care for delicate systems. It spoke about two systems but did not talk about the care. Therefore, A is already also eliminated. Therefore, we are left with C, and that is the right answer. Let's go to the next paragraph, next question. I'm sorry. Both the passage support which of the following generalizations? Let's check. The human body and environment are delicate systems that require balance to function properly. There are many similarities between the systems that make up the human body and the water cycle. We were not talking about water cycle at all. Therefore, we will deduce this in the beginning itself. Acid rain. Now here, you are talking about both the passages. So if one option talks about only one kind of a system in the environment or in the body, definitely that is eliminated for sure. Okay. The next, third option. Acid rain is an important issue that will continue to impact the environment until we reduce the use of fossil oils. So what will happen to the second passage? Therefore, this is eliminated. The D is medical treatment is necessary when the pH of the process person's blood drops below 35 or rises above 7.5. As I have already told you, it talks about both the passages. So when it talks about both the passages, we should have an option that support both the passages. So therefore, this is also eliminated, leaving this as the answer. I hope the technique is clear. This requires a little more time. At least not the first 7 questions or 8 questions that talk about individual passages. They're easy to score too. But definitely the last passages, last 3 questions or 4 questions that require both the passages, purpose of the passage or the silent tone or the central theme, it definitely requires more time. But we definitely cannot, you know, have that liberty of having extra time. So we have to make sure that we make enough flowchart for both the passages. Not enough, we can only make one flowchart for one passage. So we should adhere to making flowchart for each passage. If you don't want to make a flowchart, you can just underline, like I underlined in the beginning. Or if you feel that there is a need to write, we can make a small note. We can just make a note of 2 or 3 words. We are not going to write an entire sentence. So the time is lost writing the entire sentence. Okay. So therefore, it is easier for us to go back, bounce back to the questions, get the answer and come back and check the right answer. Eliminating the options is also one more skill that you have to inculcate. You have to practice, and comparatively, if you look at it, they are smaller, the passages are smaller, 4 questions from each. I mean, there are chances that 7 questions are right, 7 to 8 questions are right. So I suggest that if you have a paired passage, definitely it's a bounty, right? So this is how you have to work on a paired passage. Yes, I have taken my liberty of time trying to explain everything and making flowcharts and stuff like that. But you have the paucity of time. You cannot have the luxury of using how much of a time you would want to for a paired passage. You have to complete it in 12 minutes. If you reduce the time consumption for the rest of the questions, probably you can give some more extra minutes to the paired passage. And definitely you can score better. I suggest that paired passage, at least the individual questions, can be right, and you can have the remaining 3 or 4 questions as a, you know, something that you could play with. I mean, because in the reading section, out of 40, 52 questions, if you get 50 right, you'll get a full score of a 400 on 400. So, I mean, the entire thing actually. So, if you get a 52 or 51, definitely you will have a 400 score there. You could check the rubric. You'll understand the things better. That is really going to be helpful. And one more thing about paired passages is that they're basically smaller. Take the advantage of the smaller passages. Rather than fumbling through an entire passage, I suggest take the advantage of a smaller passage and work on it. This can actually increase your score. I mean, 7 to 8 questions right is not a small score that you're going to build up. And I suggest that please read a lot. Reading a lot will definitely help you working out faster. You can, you know, create your, you know, you can play with your, you can adhere to time management. You can manage your time better. And you can also work on simple things like vocabulary. You have seen in all the passages that I'm picking up, you will not see extraordinary, vocabulary. Please understand, you need not, you know, read 3,500 words. You know, many books say that, you know, you have to improve your vocabulary and have to take somewhere, but you are still in the undergraduate level, and the kind of vocabulary that you need is not as much as you need for a GRE exam, because that's a graduate level exam. So in every curriculum, the kind of vocabulary one tests is in accordance with is at par with their age. So please understand that you need not require some extraordinary vocabulary to ace the test. Whatever I'm doing whatever I'm giving you and whatever I'll be giving you further would be more than enough for you to ace the test. So guys, all the best. See how I'm going, dealing with it, how I'm eliminating the options and how I'm working on the passage. And I'm giving you a detailed explanation about how you have to go. You have to underline, you can underline. You'll be provided with a pencil in the hall. So you can definitely underline the passage. You can flip the pages because it's not a, I'm using a computer digitalized system, whereas you will not be taking a digitalized test. It is still a paper and pen test. So you need not flip your, you can just flip your pages and find your answer. Unlike me going further and after the way I'm flipping around. So you need not do that too. So all the very best. Please practice a lot, read a lot. Even if you're not doing the answers, I suggest before, keep reading a lot. Keep reading a lot of journals, and then definitely you'll be able to do it. Okay, guys, so that's for today. And thank you for your support. And please, I hope this session was informative, and all the best for your examination. Thank you so much.